Hi everyone, welcome to Museum Week 2020. My name is Medhavi and I'm going to be your host for this live video. We're just going to wait for more people to join in. Joining us today is Ruta Vaghmare from the Bhavdaji Lad Museum. Sorry about that, Ruta. And Aparna Andhare from MSMS Museum, which is the Maharaja Sawai Man Singh Second Museum in Jaipur. We're going to answer anything that you want to know. Okay. I'm going to just pin this comment up. Right. Okay, great. So let's get started, guys. As most of you know, there are some 12 of you here and more are joining in. So I will just for a little moment, please bear with me. Every year we have Museum Week introduce 7 themes to us, one hashtag for each day, and museums everywhere globally share unique content tailored to that particular day's hashtag. For India, it is especially exciting because we don't get to see enough content. We can't get enough of Indian museums is how I should really put it. So we are very excited. Also, because every year for the last few years, participation from India has just grown, and we are hoping that more of you get to join us this year. If you're a museum supporter who's watching this, or you are a fan of a certain museum, please push them to participate, or you can share content from their social media pages or content that you have access to, or pictures that you might have clicked at any museum visit using the certain hashtags for each day. So I'm going to quickly introduce the hashtags for each day. The overall theme for this year is togetherness. We are all in this together. Community vibes are strong right now more than ever. We all know how the other is feeling. So the first theme that we have is heroes, celebrating unsung heroes. Now, the interpretation of heroes can be anything. It can, the first artwork that comes to my mind when I heard the theme the first time around was Nilima Sheikh's Salaam Chetri, in which she pays a tribute to all the nurses from Kerala. So that was the first artwork that came to my mind. But as the Partition Museum might show us, I'm hoping that they do, I hope they're listening. I will at least tell them. but another way could be just showing Prannath Mago, who's an artist who volunteered at a certain refugee camp. That could be a hero. So a hero could be anybody, depends on your collection. The second theme that we're looking at is culture in quarantine, which a lot of us have already seen the Getty Museum challenge, where people are getting inspired by artwork and dressing up or rearranging objects at home to look like we are all a piece of art. So basically it's just to do that, right? So have fun. A lot of museums, including the Museum of Art and Photography in Bangalore and a lot of other museums, have already put out this challenge. Kiran Nadar Museum of Art, and I remember seeing someone who dressed up like Amrita Shergill wearing a red shawl. That was really good. So participate if you're a museum fan. Just look at any artwork from any museum, dress up like that. That's the second theme. The third theme is togetherness, Together MW, which is again the overall theme which I already told you about. The fourth theme is museum moments. So this is literally like Throwback Thursday to any museum visit, any special moments. If you're a museum participating, you can probably share behind the scene moments that were special to you, exhibition moments that were unique as an experience for your visitors, or something that you really miss right now. So that could be museum moments. Another theme for the next day is Climate MW, a really, really, really important conversation. I cannot stress enough on really right now, but climate can be anything. It can be talk about ancient environment friendly practices. It can be nature, it can be anything that you can connect with the conversation on climate. Another theme would be technology. We are ODing on it literally right now. Technology could be any virtual tours you have, any games that you've been promoting, anything. Think of virtual events also that you want to sort of host on any of these days. It can be a lecture on climate by a professor, an art historian, anybody streamed to your YouTube. You can look at Museum Week in a vast way that way. It doesn't just have to be a social media tweeting, Instagramming campaign. Another theme that we have is dreams and W. This could be hopes that you have and dreams that you have for the future, or how dreams have been significant, a painting based on a dream, an artwork based on a dream. So dreams MW signifies that. And finally, I think, yeah, that's going to be the end before we get on to International Museum Day on Monday. So this is the run up to that. Without taking away a lot of time, I want to share that Ruta has very kindly agreed to sort of talk to us about her experience. Bhavdaji Lar is one of the museums that has been participating in Museum Week for very, very long now. They're superb with their social media game. So let's invite Ruta to ask her questions that we might have. If you're a museum or someone participating for the first time, please don't be shy. Ask away anything. Don't hold back. So yeah, I'm just going to add Ruta in and I'll let her introduce herself. We're waiting for her to accept. And we're almost there. We're connecting. Hi, Ruta.
Hi, how are you? You can hear me, right?
I'm good. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay, great. So Ruta, how are you doing today?
Good, very excited to be on Instagram live with you.
I'm just going to have to rake up my volume just a bit. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
So Ruta, we are going to, if you can just introduce yourself quickly to everybody.
Sure. I'm the assistant curator at the Dr. Bhavdaji Lar Museum. I look after education activities for schools, colleges, family groups, as well as collections research management along with the rest of the team. I manage the social media handle with the team's input, and it's been exciting. I've been there for about 7 years now working at the museum. So it's been an exciting journey.
Wow. That's great to know. And we've seen your journey with Bhavdaji Lar's increasing number of followers across social media. It's something that's awesome.
Absolutely.
Ruta, tell me that you've been participating for so many years on Museum Week. What has your experience been like, and how important is this event to the museum's event calendar?
It's actually a very exciting event. We look forward to this every year when we start participating in Museum Week. It's been very special because I remember the museum really actively launched ourselves on social media in 2015, in fact, 4 months before Museum Week came up as a concept, and that was the first sort of a digital campaign we participated in. So it has always been special with the concept of 7 hashtags, 7 objects, and 7 stories. And in a museum which really puts a premium on storytelling like Bhavdaji Lar Museum does, this is a perfect opportunity to sort of diversify on what platforms and in what ways we were telling those stories.
Right.
It's been a great experience.
It's been a great experience as an audience to see these stories as well every year during Museum Week. I really look forward to everything that you guys post. You guys really interpret it differently.
Yes.
Yes. So I wanted to ask that, has Museum Week and all these hashtags always been an online-only event for you, or have you also sort of added on to create physical events in the past using the hashtags?
So far, it has been an only online event. because there is constantly so much going on within the week, a medium week also, on our on-ground events, participation in different kinds of programs. We always have exhibitions going on. So there is parallel programming going in that direction as well. So we have kept a week right now very consciously as an online event to push our digital participation.
Right. And what has been some of your favorite hashtags so far? What have you enjoyed completely or something that you remember?
Sure. One from right the first year in 2016 was Secret MW. This was extremely fun.
Yes.
And I think a lot of museums really came up with things that people didn't know, or things that were recorded but people didn't really notice it.
Yeah.
So for example, we spoke about the sort of a small box that's buried under the museum's chief cornerstone. And this was in some books and things, but people didn't talk about it on social media. And then we put it up and it was really fun exercise. And of course, another one has been Women MW. That has been a very important hashtag to look at women's representation in collections. And it's so important for, I think, all museums to take a look back and look at it through that perspective.
Right. I remember Secrets MW, and Women MW has been a recurring theme over the years, but I also remember, I have to share that I never knew about CSMBS being a world war, you know, a hospital during those times.
Yes,
there were
a
these
hospital,
kind of
yes.
moments that you all came up with. I think that was really exciting. This year, it's all different this year. We're not at the museum. How are you preparing? And is there any advice that you have for museums who might be participating for the first time, but might be feeling, oh, we don't have all the object images? And generally, what is your advice and how are you preparing during this time?
So it's definitely difficult. When Museum Week ran that poll a few weeks ago, asking whether they should still go ahead, I think this was the concern most museums have, that we don't have that kind of access to database.
Yeah.
But I think this has also provided an opportunity to all of us who had to lock down almost instantaneously and not have access to as much database of images as we have liked, to sort of rethink of how we will tell the stories in a fresh way.
Yeah.
Images can never get old, especially good images from a museum. You can always think of stories, and that's the creativity push, I think, that all curatorial teams are doing really splendidly during this lockdown time. And for us also, this has been a challenge. So we have looked at certain themes and recreated certain programs online, looking at what we already have. And an advice to museums, again, would be work together. The teamwork has, I think, been a really great backbone of being so successful for any museum doing very good virtual programming.
Yeah.
Teamwork, of course, and having, because Museum Week has already released this hashtag, we have enough time to think about what we want to say and sort of take it seamlessly through the collections we have online right now, rather than being bogged down about what we don't have.
Right. I can understand. I think Alia from the Manchester Museum also just sort of is echoing your thoughts here that this is a challenge across museums right now. Personally, I have volunteered for the Chandigarh Museum a lot, and we had to just when the lockdown slightly opened, someone had to go in and get the hard drive out so we can have access to the images. But it has been such a super difficult time. But on the contrary, I have seen an interesting thing emerged, that people who have visited museums have started to share images and pictures that they have taken. So it's an interesting opportunity to explore the community togetherness there. And I like how you highlighted that it's a team effort for the entire museum. This is specifically for all the museums that are hearing, that have a separate social media team, a separate curatorial team. We must come together, and this is also the core theme of Museum Week this year, together. So that's something that we want to promote this year as well, togetherness. But Ruta, tell me something. What is something new that or exciting that people can look forward to? From Bhavnaji Raj Museum this year.
We are definitely very excited about the culture in quarantine. We've been using this hashtag on and off since the lockdown started to share on our posts. But that's a challenge of the Getty Museum started, and we are very excited because we haven't tried it out, and we have so much material that we can ask people to sort of imitate and come up. Let's see what fun exercises they come up with. Another thing that the Dreams NW is something we are very excited about. We are going to be posting some interesting things of where the museum's vision lies going forward. So that should be something that people should definitely look out for. That will be interesting.
Right. That's definitely something. I think someone is also asking us, should you be strict when abiding by the themes of Museum Week? Can you interpret hashtags in creative ways? Yes. I mean, you don't have to be strict at all. This is a fun campaign, and I think fun comes from being creative and experimental, just as Ruta right now said. But one story can have so many interpretations. And so, yeah, that's something that we are going to look forward to, Ruta. Thank you. And guys, please follow Thaudajilat @BDL Museum for some really fun content. They have Tuesday trivias. They have treasure hunts going on in general also. So, Ruta, is there anything that you might want to promote right here, right now?
Yes, definitely. Our treasure hunts, our Tuesday talks, where we are revisiting an archive of talks done in the past, and our Flashback Fridays, where we discuss contemporary art that has been acquired by the museum, and especially in relevance to what's happening in around us right now. So that's very interesting for those who haven't had a chance to look at some of these exhibitions, which happened before the social media boom came about.
Right. And just before you go, I know I just saw an interesting question pop up by, I think, Shriyanka, who asked if there is going to be any regional language promotion. I know Sarmaya and a couple of others have been putting up regional content. You guys do tours in regional languages as well. So is there going to be that access? Is that going to be addressed this time during Museum Week as well?
We are definitely trying for that. We have some content already online that's in regional languages, like virtual cards. We had them both in English and Marathi. So we'll definitely be trying to do a post in Marathi as well as in English for Museum Week.
That would be wonderful. Thank you. I will learn a little Marathi by then. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Ruta. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, Madhavi.
Watching, and we are going to have Aparna join us now. And see you, Ruta. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Take care. Bye.
Yeah. I'm now going to just quickly. I'm just going to call Aparna from the Sawai Man Singh Jaipur Museum. I'm sure you've all been there, and it's one of those very, very exciting museums. So yeah, I mean, let's get Aparna to join us. Aparna, we're just waiting for her to confirm, and she's connecting in. Everybody's been to Jaipur and clicked those amazing pictures at their museum, but hi, Aparna.
Hello. How nice to see you. Yes.
This is our first virtual call.
I can't believe that it is, actually, given how much time you and I spend online. If this is the first time we're doing this, well,
yes,
then we must thank Museum Week for it.
Yes, we must thank Museum Week for it. So let me remind everybody who has just joined in, this year's Museum Week theme is togetherness. We are looking at 7 days, 17. So each day there is a new hashtag to share your pictures with, to share content with your community. Or if you're a museum fan, use the hashtag to reinterpret a museum artwork that you might have seen. So yes, follow all the India museums that are participating. You will keep seeing them showcasing their content. And
you've got an India Museum hashtag. You've got an India Museum hashtag as well, don't you?
Yes, we have. Oh, yes. Thank you so much, Raparna, for reminding us. Please hashtag MW India to look at all the Indian content coming in from Museum Week this year. We are looking at an increased participation like every year. the time that I started with Museum Week, there were all of 3 museums in India that were participating. That number has grown to be over 20, and this is just really exciting. So, Aparna, even you were, you know, can you please first introduce yourself before I start off with all the questions?
Well, my name is Aparna. I am a Bombay girl living in Jaipur. I work at the City Palace. The museum is called Maharaja Savai Man Singh, the second museum. It's quite a mouthful, and Medhavi gets it right each time. So, yay for that. Each time. No. Don't worry. But thank you. So, we basically are a museum of royal culture and art, and we're arguably one of the finest collections of paintings. Our building is, we're a set of buildings. Because we're in the Golden Triangle of Delhi, Agra, and Jaipur, we get lots of guests. But I hope you've come to see it.
Oh, yes. And they have an excellent cafe. Not cafe, but...
Yes, two now.
Yes. Oh, now there are two.
Yes. There's a little cafe, and there's a nice restaurant as well. We'll have the best pizzas in the country, I have to say that. But this is not to plug Baradari. Although I'm going to get brownie points for that.
This time I get to ask you that, Aparna, you guys were one of the, first palace museums. I mean, there are a lot of palace museums in India, but you guys were one of the first ones to start participating in Museum Week. And even though when you started participating, it was only on Facebook and not on Instagram and Twitter, you guys didn't have accounts there at that time. Do you think that impacted your participation? Did you have fun? What was your experience like?
So, thank you for asking that. Yes, we began our social media journey, as it were, on Facebook, because I think for us to reach out to a certain audience is different. When Instagram comes in, because it was a new platform, it had so many visuals, we weren't sure how we want to negotiate putting the collection on, and how do you reach out, because it's a different audience. We're still not on Twitter, we're restricting ourselves to Facebook and to Instagram, essentially saying let's do the best we can on these two platforms where we have a bit of fanfall, we have a bit of, we have a community going. And Museum Week was really handy because it can be a little bit isolating here in Jaipur. We've got our colleagues at the Albert Hall, but what is happening in museums around the world? Frequently we've seen, there's a need to join this community, to have conversations, to upskill ourselves even, and to be a part of a larger sort of community. Yes, to be a part of a larger world. And I think palace museums tend to be forgotten in that sense because, unlike the Bharati Lab, for example, we don't collect contemporary art. So how do we stay relevant? We stay relevant by putting the collection out, by sort of rethinking parts of the collection, and people to come in to respond to it.
Right.
Although we do have a new gallery now. So we've shown Claire Arney's work with Tark. We've had Vazvo come in recently to launch his book, and Sonika Soni was there. So, we do get people in, but it's nice to be a part of the present moment.
Right, absolutely, and see what others are posting. Sometimes it's just inspiring to, just see other people's works and their interpretation of a certain artwork too. Right?
Always. Yeah. Always. It's very easy to get caught otherwise into your own jargon, as it were.
Right, that's true. So this year, how are you making it special for your community, especially given that you are a museum with photography restrictions? What does it mean to your museum?
Our restrictions for photography is that we don't let you take pictures inside our gallery. Now, there are two reasons for this. One is that you've come to our museum, so you know that it's not a purpose-built museum. We've had these buildings and we've had to fit galleries in. Now, when we get thousands of visitors, if everyone stops to take a picture, we're going to have a roadblock. Plus, our showcases are old and all of that. And then, of course, we have concerns about image and copyright and all of that. So that aside, everyone's welcome to take pictures of the courtyard. They're welcome to, walk around and get pictures. So, for example, everyone's got a picture in front of the painted gateway, which is also on a book cover. What it means for us to be able to share some of our images is that we can bring our collection to our audience.
Right.
And now when we can't get to our collection either, it's a good opportunity for us to revisit some of these things and to push for the saying that the internet or social media isn't just something that you do on the side. It needs to be a part of the mainstream conversation. It's sort of almost as important as conservation is. Isn't it? It's an important part of that. So that conversation has begun, I think, and not only in our museum, but in museums around the country, and they've seen that it has value. You and I have had a chat about this and lamented how, you know, with the treatment that internet has over the last few years.
True, I know. but let's hope that is changed. I mean, it will change, hopefully, someday sooner. And I think
I was saying it's changing now. It's changing as we speak. The fact that so many of us are on it, you know, and we're getting ideas. We have more flexibility to do things, which shows us that attitudes are changing.
Absolutely. Sorry, you were saying. I know someone messaged me today saying that we cannot do without digital anymore at our museum, and I'm like, this is a dream come true for me to hear from a museum that for once you know, for once when I ask, are you participating in Museum Week, I hear a definitive yes, instead of a, we'll let you know, we are figuring. So I'm really glad that these times have also pushed us towards raking up conversations online. But Aparna, I also want to ask that...
That's a good silver lining.
So I meant to ask...
I think the silver lining.
Yeah, it's a silver lining there. I meant to ask how Museum Week and these
kinds
of
lag,
have allowed you to connect with your community.
So I think that two things that are happening that are very interesting. One is that I'm paying more attention to demographics. So a museum like ours gets a lot of footfall, and you know, so we're not reaching out to saying, unlike many museums in the West, saying, "Hamare museum mein aao, please, hamare museum mein aao, dekho." What we're trying to do is to be a space that people will come back to discover themselves, to explore our library, to come and look at these pictures, to use the museum's collection as a part of their own creative process. Jaipur, as you know, is quite a creative city. And we'd like to take this to a point where you don't drop off your visiting relatives and say, I'll meet you at the restaurant for lunch, but you will come in with them and explore and find these things. What is happening now, I think, is that our demographics are changing and we're also talking to a more local audience, Jaipur is sort of revisiting the museum. We have a new gallery, the painting and photography gallery. So we hope that more people will come in and see, and that we're bringing a bit of happiness in these dark times. I think a bit of beauty is what we need. Poetry is what we need. We also need to find out where we are going with a lot of this. The world has survived real dark moments, and I think without art, where would we be? So that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to basically be a little bit light-hearted about things. I think what we'd like to do to, you know, make sure that we don't, all of us can't go grim at this point.
About this, yes, true, absolutely, because I think this is that 1 week where we are also expecting fun content for museums to sort of push up the mood and sort of lighten it up maybe a little, and also give us things to think about, also, like, you know, reflect on in general, like the heroes theme that helps us reflect that who are the heroes, climate, dreams, what are we really chasing after, what are our hopes.
Also helps us to revisit what it means for us to have our own collection. I think every museum, and which is what I like about Museum Week, I think that the hashtags are sort of broad enough to be able to, you can look at them from different angles. So a hero to you or to me, you were thinking of Neelima Sheikh, I thought of the Durga Path. That was my, no, I'm not going to use a Durga Path image. Durga Path, for those of us who, is a series of 103 folios. It's a beautiful district, bashing up the cutest looking demons you will see ever. If you haven't seen a picture, please go back into our Instagram. I'm sure there's a Dona Park somewhere, so you can take a look.
I will check it out for sure. But yeah. I'm personally really looking forward to your content as well, because these are for me or for others like me who have been to your museum, but I mean, know that it's a great collection, but just want to see it because we don't have pictures. It's a great moment for us to see.
You can get our catalogs, Medhavi. Get our catalogs. You can take the museum home with you. We have some very beautifully illustrated and scholarly catalogs as well. So Robert Elgood has his on arms and armor. Rahul Jain has written ours on the textile. We've got Jalta and Nalini Venkateshwaran have written. Have edited our painting and photography, so you can get pictures. And
thank you. If this is available on an online shop, please enjoy it during museum technology bring you as well.
Back.
Right. So, Amarna, what have been your favorite moments of Museum Week so far?
That's a good idea. Making a note of it. That the conversations that happen both before it and during it are most fun. Say, "Acha, ab kya karein?" So the begins, and then we, you know, ideas get thrown around. It's very interesting to go back into the collection and saying, "Okay, what shall we do?" The challenge now is I can't walk around the gallery and say this, this, and this. So I'm also sort of revisiting my own memories of this museum, which is less than 5 kilometers away from me, but totally unreachable. So that used to be great fun. And the fact that, you know, someone from Japan is going to write and say that, "I didn't know you had this. This is wonderful." Or someone has, you know, someone will DM with a personal person and, you know, has a family connection, or they have, you know, those sort of stories become exciting. And it's great fun to talk about objects and to, you know, to be able to deal with them and to bring them to friends. I think that's my favorite part.
I love what you just said, that someone, these global connections are so important. I remember when the Ashmolean Museum shared a dice from Mohenjo-Daro for Play MW one of the years. It was so nice to see it because we don't get to see these collections otherwise. It's great to come across things and interact with others. But thank you so much, Aparna, for sharing your time today. Is there any advice you would like to give to museums that are going to participate this year, who might not be on Twitter and who might not be as active on Instagram, but I mean, you're still acing it?
I think that it's fun. It's important to have fun. And it's also important to get a colleague to proofread. We were finalizing our content and I realized that I'd misspelled some words because, you know, one does. So I think that it's important to put our best foot forward as a museum, but it's also important to not take ourselves too seriously and to respond. We're just so cloistered in our own gateways. And it's important to talk to another museum, to, you know, Ruta and I, of course, know each other outside of this circle, but to be able to repost and create that conversation. A few weeks ago, museums were tagging each other and sending each other pictures and postcards, and I thought that was just lovely. So to be a part of that community, at least on the Desi level, is important. So, you know, we're all friends. That's my advice.
Yes. Thank you for that advice. I hope museums are listening. Museums, the one thing that I personally really love about Museum Week is how all museums start to like each other's work, comment on each other's work, and they're not just rushing to push their content through.
So there's also a fair bit of jealousy.
Yes.
Like, I can't believe I didn't think of some lines that Ruta and her team have thought of. So Ruta's line, there are a couple of posts and I said, "I thought of that joke, but she beat me to it." So, you know, there's that. There's also a bit of that.
But just to keep you guys in that friendly race, we will keep posting everybody's impressions and best posts from the day, just to sort of just to sort of nudge you all a little and create that healthy jealousy amidst everybody.
It's a competition, is it?
As long as it's healthy and good, we'll have fun this museum week, and we will try and give rest to our fingers and.
I think you're all going into, so the question that I have for my colleagues and friends is, how are they dealing with digital just now? Because I feel that I'm inching closer and closer to complete burnout, where, you know, there's so much, and I think FOMO has gone out of the window. Now it's like, I don't know what to do. So, you know, I don't know how colleagues are dealing with this sort of thing.
Ruta is right here with us, echoing our belief that yes, it's great that museums are coming together, and let's hope that more and more enthused cutlets about museums sort of join the tribe. And yes, I'm going to sign off now, but thank you, Aparna, for joining us. Just
thank you for having me, Medhavi. Thanks, Ruta.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm just going to... yes, guys, so just got to say goodbye. Thank you for joining in this live session. If you have any questions, leave them here. If you don't have questions, great. Please participate in Museum Week. If a museum that you love is not participating, help them. See what you can do to help them participate. And that's about it. You know where to find me. If you have any additional questions, please reach out. Thank you, and as Aparna reminded me, hashtag MWIndia, and you will find everything that India has been sharing. So thank you again. Bye-bye.